लेट्स स्टार्ट। तो अवर टॉपिक इज एल्डिहाइड कीटोन्स एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। तो इट इज फ्रॉम अवर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री एंड चैप्टर नंबर 12। प्रीवियसली वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट एल्कोहल फिनॉल एंड ईथर, एंड इन एल्कोहल फिनॉल एंड ईथर वी सो दैट कार्बन इज कनेक्टेड टू ऑक्सीजन बाई ए सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड। कार्बन इज कनेक्टेड टू ऑक्सीजन बाई ए सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड इन Here in this chapter we will study about aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acid in which carbon is connected to double covalent bond to the oxygen atom. Carbon is connected to the double covalent bond with oxygen atom, and this group is called carbonyl group. This group is called carbonyl group. So aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acids are called carbonyl compound. Aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acids are called carbonyl compound, and the derivatives of carboxylic acid, the derivatives of carboxylic acids are also called carbonyl compound. We will study what are the derivatives. Derivatives compounds are those compounds which are formed by the main compound. When we form a number of other compounds with the main compound, then the other compounds are called derivative of the main compound. So we will study all this in this chapter, and this is the general introduction. That in 11 chapter number 11 or in unit number 11 we have learned the organic compound in functional group carbon oxygen single bond, and the carbon oxygen single bond was the alcoholic group. Alcoholic group is represented by single covalent bond OH, in which the carbon was connected to the Yes, in alcoholic chapter, in chapter number 11, we have studied that in alcohol, phenol, and ether, the carbon is connected to oxygen with a single covalent bond. But in chapter number 12, in aldehyde, a carbonyl group is present, and carbonyl group is represented by this manner. This is the carbonyl group. Means carbon is connected to oxygen by a double covalent bond. Carbon is connected to the oxygen with a double covalent bond. And these two valencies of carbon is satisfied with the other alkyl group, and the alkyl group may be same or may be different. So all this we will study in this chapter. So aldehyde ketones are carboxylic acids and derivatives are called carbonyl compound. We have discussed. So how we can represent aldehyde? So aldehyde, to represent aldehyde, this is the carbonyl group. This is the carbonyl group, and two valencies of carbonyl groups are free. If we satisfy the both valencies of carbonyl group with hydrogen only, in case of aldehyde, then we get a aldehyde. If we satisfy both the valencies of carbon with hydrogen, then we get a simplest aldehyde, and the simplest aldehyde is called methanol or formaldehyde. This is the simplest aldehyde. It is only possible in the case of aldehyde that the two valences of carbonyl group are satisfied with the same hydrogen. So it is the simplest compound of aldehyde. This is the carbonyl group. Again, I am drawing the carbonyl group. This is the carbonyl group, and these are the two valences of carbonyl group. And if I attach here, or if I attach an alkyl group in the left hand side, and in right hand side I attach hydrogen, then it is called aldehyde. It is the representation of aldehyde. It is a representation of aldehyde. And here R, what is R? And R equal to alkyl group. R equal to alkyl group. R may be any of the alkyl group, and maybe aryl also. Alkyl group. R equal to alkyl group. So I think this is clear to all of you. Yes. So this was the representation of aldehyde. Second, this is the carbonyl group. Again, I am drawing the carbonyl group. And if the two valences of carbonyl group is satisfied with the carbon. If the two valences of the carbon is satisfied with the if the two valences of carbon is satisfied with the alkyl group, then we get ketone. Then we get a ketone. This is the ketone. RCOR. It is a ketone. Okay. So in ketone, the alkyl group may be same and may be different. And if the alkyl group are same in both the left portion and right portion, it is called symmetrical ketone. And if the alkyl groups are different, like in this manner, then the ketones are called asymmetrical ketones. For example, alkyl group. What are the alkyl group? Alkyl groups are formed when one hydrogen is removed from the alkane. We know this is the alkane CH4 methane. And if I remove one hydrogen from methane, then I get CH3. And what is CH3? CH3 is the alkyl group. And the name of the CH3 is methyl. It is methyl. So now you have understood that what is alkyl group. Similarly, this is the C2H6. C2H6 means ethane. And if I remove one hydrogen from ethane, I get single covalent bond C2H5. And C2H5 is ethyl group. And ethyl group is a alkyl group. So by this manner, we get alkyl group. So these are the alkyl groups are attached. If both the alkyl groups are same with the carbonyl group, then it is called ketone, symmetrical ketone. And if both the alkyl groups are different, then it is called asymmetrical ketone. Another third important carbonyl compound that we have to study in this chapter is carboxylic acid. It is carboxylic acid. So how carboxylic acid can be represented? Very simple. Carboxylic acid, to represent the carboxylic acid, this is the carbonyl group, and the one valency of carbonyl group is satisfied with the alkyl group, and the another valency of the carbonyl group is satisfied with the hydroxyl group, which then we get the functional group of COOH. It is the functional group of carboxylic acid, and RCOOH, it is the representation of carboxylic acid. Now I think it is clear to all of you. In this chapter, we have to study about the derivatives of carboxylic acids also. So what are the derivatives? As I have discussed, the derivatives are formed with the main compound only. Okay, so this is the derivative of carboxylic acids. So how carboxylic acids derivatives are formed? This is the carboxylic acid RCOOH. Then what we have to do to form derivatives of carboxylic acid? We simply remove this OH group. We simply remove this OH group and attach another groups. So another groups may be halide. If we add halide, then we get RCOX, and RCOX is called acid halide. It is called acid halide. And X may be chloride, bromide, iodide, like that. So if we write RCOCl in the place of X, what is X? X is the halide, and halide may be chloride, bromide, iodide, all these things. So if I write Cl in the place of X, then I get acid chloride, and acid chloride is the derivative of carboxylic acid. Similarly, this is the formula of carboxylic acid RCOOH, and if I remove this OH group and put NH2, then I get acid amide, RCONH2. It is called acid amide. It is the derivative of carboxylic acid. Similarly, if I remove OH and put O सिंगल बॉन्ड सी ओ आर इन द प्लेस ऑफ ओ एच देन आई गेट ए फॉर्मूला ऑफ एसिड एनहाइड्राइड. दीज आर द एसिड एनहाइड्राइड एंड व्हाट आर द आर एंड दिस आर दीज आर द एल्काइल ग्रुप दैट वी हैव डिस्कस अर्लियर. एंड इफ सिमिलरली इफ आई रिमूव द ओ एच ग्रुप ऑफ द कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड एंड एड ओ आर देन आई गेट esters and the esters you know very well esters are a pleasant smelling substance which have very good smelling compound. These were the only introduction of the aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acids. So it is again very important that aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acids are found in plants and animals. So it is a large variety of aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acids that are found in plants and animals. And the aldehyde ketones and carboxylic acids give fragrance and flavor to the nature. It is very important for biological process also. Very important compound in the biological process of the life. So simple and most important aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids are given in the examples. This is the example of vanillin, and it is a aldehyde. It is a aldehyde because aldehyde group CHO group is attached to the compound. So it is a vanillin, and it is extracted from vanilla beans. It is extracted from the vanilla beans from the plant product. And this is salicylaldehyde. It is salicylaldehyde, and salicylaldehyde is very important compound in Reimer-Tiemann reaction. In Reimer-Tiemann reaction, it is very important reaction, dear students. So salicylaldehyde, comes from meadowsweets. It is a plant product also, and it is a cinnamaldehyde. It is a cinnamaldehyde, and it is obtained from cinnamon. So these all are obtained from plants. Now we are going to discuss the nomenclature of aldehydes and ketones. So how nomenclature of aldehydes and ketones are considered. So in this point, we will discuss the common name and IUPAC name of the some aldehyde and ketones, important aldehydes and ketones. See, this is the simplest aldehyde, CHO. What is CHO, dear student? CHO is the aldehydic functional group for aldehyde. CHO is the functional group for aldehyde. And if I write H, then I get the a molecule, and this molecule is called 4-aldehyde. And 4-aldehyde is the common name of this compound. SCHO is called 4-aldehyde. And IUPAC name of this compound is methanol, because only one carbon is there. One carbon means functional group carbon is there. So functional group carbon will also consider for the naming. So only one carbon is there. So one carbon means methane. And for aldehyde, we add suffix al. Al suffix is added to the main root word. So main root word is methane plus L. So formula, so IUPAC name will be methanol. Similarly, there are two carbon, one and two, and is the common name. Common name is acetaldehyde, very important common name, and the IUPAC name is ethanol. Similarly, CH3, CH2, CHO, the number of carbon is 1, 2, and 3. There are three carbon. So three carbon means the common name is propionaldehyde, and the IUPAC name is propanol. This is the IUPAC name of this compound. Next, the number of carbon is 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there are 4 carbon. So there are 4 carbon means the common name is butyraldehyde, and the IUPAC name is butanol. Similarly, the number of कार्बन इज 1, 2 एंड 3, 3 कार्बन एंड एट कार्बन नंबर 2 1 सब्स्टिट्यूट इज अटैच एंड द सब्स्टिट्यूट इज CH3. CH3 मीन्स मिथाइल ग्रुप. सो IUPAC नेम इज आइसो ब्यूटाइल ब्यूटाइल एल्डिहाइड. आइसो ब्यूटाइल्डिहाइड इट इज आई सॉरी इट इज कॉमन नेम ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड बिकॉज दिस इज आइसो ग्रुप. दिस इज आइसो ग्रुप. इट इज आइसो ग्रुप. एंड वाई इट इज कॉल्ड ब्यूटाइल्डिहाइड बिकॉज नंबर ऑफ कार्बन आर 4, 1, 2, 3 एंड 4. 4 कार्बन आते. सो इट इज ग्रुप रिप्रेजेंटेड आइसो एंड देर आर 4 कार्बन. सो इट इज कॉल्ड ब्यूटर and CHO means aldehyde. So common name is isobutyraldehyde. See, in common name there is no any rule. There is no rule to determine their common name. But in IUPAC name, there are certain rules to follow. We can give the name of the compounds by follow their rules only. So the IUPAC name of this compound is 2-methylpropanol. 2-methyl because 8 number carbon number 2 one methyl group is attached. So number of carbon 1 2 and 3 in the main chain. So in main chain there are 3 carbon. So the compound is propanol and 2-methyl is a substitute group. So we put here. So 2-methylpropanol IUPAC name. And this is another compound and the name of common name of this compound is phenylacetaldehyde. Phenylacetaldehyde. This is the phenyl group C6H5. This is the C6H5 group. And C6H5 is called phenylic group. And CH3CHO is the acetaldehyde. So the common name become phenylacetaldehyde. And IUPAC name is 3-phenylethanol. Because the number of carbon 1, 2. Phenylacetaldehyde. And CH2 double bond CH, CHO. The common name of this compound is acrolein. IUPAC name is prop2-in-1-L. So prop2-in because there are three carbon 1, 2 and 3 and at carbon number 2 and 3 there is a double covalent bond. So it is the name of the compound become prop2-in-1-L. Similarly CH3CH double bond CH CHO the common name is crotonaldehyde and the IUPAC name become but2-in-1-L. So these are the common name and the IUPAC name of the simplest aldehyde. This is the C6H5CHO. C6H5CHO is called benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde or it is also called benzene carbaldehyde. See, common name, this is the benzene ring and this CHO is not considered the carbon for this ring. So the common name is given benzene carbaldehyde. Benzene, then it is carbon and it is the CHO group means aldehyde group. So benzene carbaldehyde and the IUPAC name is benzene benzaldehyde. It is very important compound. Very important compound in the aldehyde group. And this is the phthalaldehyde, phthalaldehyde. And the IUPAC name is benzene 1,2-dicarbaldehyde. This is the benzene. This is benzene and 1,2-dicarbaldehyde. So I think this is clear to all of you. Structures of carbonyl group. So in structure of carbonyl group, the carbonyl atom is sp2 hybridized and forms 3 sigma bonds. See, in the carbonyl carbon atom means this one carbon is called carbonyl carbon atom. This carbon is called carbonyl carbon atom. it is connected to three sigma bonds, and the hybridization of this carbon is sp2 hybridized. The fourth valence of electrons of carbonyl compound atoms remains in its p orbital and form pi bond with oxygen with sideways overlap with p orbital of oxygen. So what happened in the case of carbonyl compound, this is the carbonyl compound, and this carbonyl compound form three sigma bond. This is the sigma bond with the oxygen, one sigma bond with the oxygen. This is another sigma bond, and this is the third one sigma bond. This is the sigma bonds comes towards our side. This is the sigma bond comes backward to our side, and this is the sigma bond in the plane itself. So it is a planar structure, and hybridization of this carbon is sp2. One fourth electron of this carbon, see here one electron, here one electron, and here one electron, and the one electrons are from the different atoms. So four electron of the carbons remain in the p orbital. This is the fourth electron of this carbon remain in the p orbital. Similarly, the electronic configuration of oxygen is, we know, the electronic configuration for oxygen is 2,6, and in the valence shell oxygen have 6 valence electron. Out of 6, 4 electrons remain as a lone pair. So there are two lone pair electrons, two pair of electrons oxygen possesses, and fifth one electrons is bonded with sigma bond with this carbon. This is the electron of the this one carbon, and this is the electron of this oxygen, and sixth electron of this carbon remains in p orbital. This is the p orbital of the oxygen. Now what happened by formation of pi bond? How carbon and oxygen form a pi bond? So p orbital of the carbon and p orbital of the oxygens comes together, and they connected by the sideways overlap. How sideways overlap? This is the p orbital of carbon. This is the p orbital of carbon. This is the p orbital of carbon, and this is the p orbital of oxygen. This is the p orbital of oxygen. This is the p orbital of oxygen. So they comes nearer and connected to the sideways. So when the orbitals overlap as a sideways overlap, then they form pi bond. They form pi bond. And electrons clouds are upside and downside. Electrons clouds are upside of the plane and downside of the plane, like this manner. So all this is written in this notes. So fourth valence electrons, p orbitals, fourth valence electron of carbonyl compound remains in its p orbitals and form pi bond with oxygen by the sideways overlap with p orbital of the oxygen. Oxygen has two lone pair of electrons. See, these are the lone pair of electrons, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the lone pair of oxygen. Carbonyl carbon. This is the carbonyl carbon, and the three atoms attached to it lie in the same plane. All are in the same plane, and the pi electrons clouds is above and below the plane. This is the plane of symmetry, and this is the pi electron cloud which is above the plane and below the plane. Similarly, for this oxygen also, the pi electron clouds of this oxygen is above the plane and below the plane, and both the clouds comes together and form a bond. So bond angles approximately 120 degree and expected of a trigonal planar structure. So carbon is connected to carbon form three sigma bond, and four bond is pi bond in the case of carbonyl compound, and the hybridization of carbon is sp2 hybridized carbon, and this is the pi electron cloud of carbon and oxygen. So it is the structures of carbonyl compound. So in carbonyl compound, the structure of this molecular formula is planar. It is a planar structure, and there is one, the bond angle of carbon, oxygen and other atom is remain same, that is 120 degree. And there is double bond in between carbon and oxygen, and this bond is called carbonyl bond, and this functional group is called carbonyl group. So I think the point is very clear to all of you. Next and very simple and important point I am going to discuss. Since the electron negativity of carbon is much more higher as compared to carbonyl carbon, the electron negativity of this carbon is only 2.5 and the electron negativity of oxygen is 3.5, then the share pair of electron is pushed towards the oxygen. So oxygen get a partially negative charge and carbon gets a partially positive charge acquire carbon and partially negative charge acquire oxygen. So oxygen react as a nucleophilic site, and this carbon act as a electrophilic site. So all these things are written in this. The share pair of electrons are pulled towards the oxygen, therefore a partial positive charge on carbon and partial negative charge on oxygen atom. The carbon act as a electrophilic and the oxygen act as a nucleophilic center, like this. The electron negativity of oxygen is 3.5, carbon has only 2.5, so share pair of electron will push towards the oxygen, and oxygen acquire a